Welcome back YouTubers to my channel for an everyday life of an age. If you're new, I'm SB Answers. I'm all about creating mental health and awareness videos and sharing my life story. So today is going to be a quick TED video based on autumn, obviously, because here in New Zealand we're actually in autumn, and hopefully you'll enjoy this. And in saying this, basically, as you may have seen in the past, some of these TED videos for some people will be based on getting to know us more as a person, of what we like and dislike, and to improve our everyday life, or to actually reflect back years to come on what life is like for us, you know, as we grow and mature into a young person. So if you're intending to be videos like I do, a bit fun and games, advocating for you guys on autism and mental health and educating you all on it, as well as maybe some travel videos here and there and some other various topics, feel free to smash that subscribe button on the bottom right hand corner and turn on Instagram so you don't miss any future videos. So as you know, as I said, these are awesome tag video, and the questions will be listed below for you guys to actually join me on the bandwagon if you wish to. And if you do wish to, don't forget to maybe tag me by basically hashtag SB Answers, as well as hashtag autumn tag video with your name or something along these lines, so that we can actually support one another. So the very first question is, do you have any autumn tradition? Long time ago, basically, I did have some autumn traditions that I carried out basically when I was younger. Be it like I used to camp a lot, I used to basically do some tramping, I used to also do some apple bobbing. Some days I'll also do some bonfires with my friends at the beach, you know, even though, as we know, sometimes as we're near autumn winter period, it's crazy, we do some crazy stuff in autumn. Also, in saying this, basically we know that in different traditions today may have changed with me, but I haven't followed through some of that anyway. Number two, what's one word you would like to describe autumn? One word I would like to describe autumn and colourful. Number three, what to go to coffee? Well, at the moment I've been trying to test out different coffees, so my go-to coffee at the moment has been some of the latte flavoured ones, be it vanilla latte, the Christmas one of the gingerbread latte, as well as basically caramel latte and mocha latte. So I'm a bit of a variation depending on my moods, obviously, when it comes down to my coffee, if I want one, or I'll just stick to my green teas and herbals, as well as some other teas. Number four, favorite thing to do on a rainy day. If it's a rainy day, sometimes basically if I'm stuck indoors, I'll be basically either doing some poetry writing, or I'll be reading a book, or else I'll be usually, if I have enough ingredients at the time, I'll be usually doing some homemade baking. Number five, favorite autumn themed TV series. I don't think I have many favorite TV themed autumn series, because I don't usually watch that much TV, because I'm usually trying to be out and about, but I can't think of any at the top of the list. So if you've got any, let me know to list them and I might answer to that question again. Number six, favorite Halloween movie.
Instead of my favorite autumn Halloween themed movie,
in this one I don't usually celebrate Halloween basically like many others that would basically in this time of day, because I don't believe in it, because obviously, you know, it's to their own.
I will list basically right now my favorite autumn themed movies. One is Forrest Gump, The Final Cut. I fully have the illustrations to illustrate the ones that I'm talking about here as well.
Number seven, what's your favorite pumpkin based food? My favorite based pumpkin food would be basically roast pumpkins, or a roasted pumpkin salad, or basically a pumpkin pie if I can try and make one. Number eight, what's your favorite book to read in autumn? My favorite book to read in autumn basically is anything that will get me in the mood to solve mysteries. So murder mystery kind of books, versus also maybe rom-com kind of romantic ones. Number nine is your favorite autumn drink in autumn. I don't have most basically a favorite autumn drink. I usually try to prep ready before winter sort of thing to have my lemon and honey drinks, versus like maybe just, let's say, turmeric latte for maybe an autumn drink, as well as maybe hot chocolate when we're nearing winter as well as autumn, just to get everything prepped and ready. Number nine, three songs that reminds you of autumn. That reminds me just of anything, just anything that gets me in the mood. So I'm an old R&B hip-hop kind of girl at heart, usually of the 80s, versus also just 10. Describe the words of three words of rain and autumn. Well, obviously there'll be colourful leaves fluttering around the footpath, or shall we say colourful leaves flowing gracefully through the wind, while the rain is slowly drizzling down onto the surfaces of the window pane, causing some calming effect. 11. What two things shows that fall has begun? The two things that I can see that fall has begun is obviously, you know, the change of the season based on your leaves basically, the change colours, as well as the leaves falling on the ground, as well as another one is for another second thing. It's just when you know that some of the bakeries or coffee shops will prepare your pumpkin related kind of themed foods and drinks. What are your plans for autumn? I don't have any plans for autumn at this point of time, because obviously now while I'm recording this, we are in almost lockdown mode as of like Wednesday. It started midnight, so if I can get this up before midnight tonight for you guys to entertain you, while I also, and saying this, will hopefully bring out more videos for you guys. The type of music I listen to will be basically anything and everything, just to keep me in the mood. So it depends on the mood. If I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm dancing around, singing and humming and doing my, you know, swimming. Meanwhile, if I'm sad and I want something sad, I'll put that on or something just to get me upbeat and dance. It depends on the mood here. Full day or full night. For me, I'd rather have an autumn like day or night. Again, that would be depending on my moods and where I'm at the point. Obviously, if I'm stuck indoors in autumn, I like listening to the soft patter of the raindrops on the windows versus also just basically the leaves. Seeing the leaves falling down gracefully off the trees and seeing them change into colour and whatnot. What's your dream Halloween holiday? My dream Halloween holiday, like I said, I don't usually do Halloween, so therefore basically for me, if it was just a dream autumn holiday, for me it will be just being away off in a cabin, tramping somewhere, you know, safe and whatnot. 15 silent nights or windy nights. Define how windy you want it, because I don't mind the wind. Like if it's soft winds, it's okay. But then again, I guess more to the point now, since I've noticed as I'm getting older, I like to have silent nights to be sleeping peacefully. 16. What do you like about autumn? What I like about autumn basically is just the colour of the leaves changing, and also just being able to still be out and about before winter hits, and when I want to snuggle up next to a cozy warm fire with some music and just hot winter foods. Cold rain or heavy fog? I like a bit of the cold rain if I'm all dressed up warm sort of thing. So that's that one. What do you like most about autumn? The three things I like most or love about autumn. Obviously, I still can go out and about, do enjoy outdoor activities, you know, if I want to remain active. And the changing of the leaves, obviously falling down, as I say, basically seeing nature at its finest. Sometimes when they, you know, change over time, every different periods of season, that give me a chance to go out and maybe put my photography skills to the test, as well as also if I had the chance to basically, for the third one, to do more crazy bonfire nights at the beaches and just have a bit of a laugh and have a bit of wine or something, just to wine and dine. My first memory of autumn basically was when I was a little girl. Obviously, like, I used to jump in puddles. Who wouldn't, basically, when it's raining? Or another one is my dad got me started doing stuff early as a young child by raking up leaves and stuff, learning how to rake leaves. Or even when I'm in the shed with dad when I was younger, basically he would be doing wood turning and I'll be his little helper and actually trying to sweep down the sawdust and whatnot, so to speak. My favorite scent of autumn will be cinnamon, nutmeg sort of thing, as well as some other calming kind of smells that I can think of, in rosehip oil and whatnot. Okay, do you like watching movies in bed or being by a fire? I'm a bit of both, depending on my mood. It depends on how cold I am. I might sit by a fire. You might see me sitting by a fire doing something, not just reading social media stuff, but maybe doing stuff that online, of basically doing a crossword puzzle or something that I usually have been saving on my website that I'm usually on. Or I'll be busy typing away, writing a blog. Or if I'm not sitting by a fire, I would likely to be watching movies, cuddle up by the fire with the movies. Have you done anything in autumn? And if so, when? In the past, as I said, basically, I used to camp a lot, so I do a lot of camping and also just being outdoors. I used to basically hike around when I was a little kid, you know, basically leading to basically Pōngana Valley out at Ashurst here in New Zealand. Also, in saying this, I used to basically camp out in Ruapehu, Taupō region, basically not where you may have seen with most of my travelling videos of late Rotorua, but based on somewhere in the Tongariro Crossing, somewhere there is a cabin up there from memory as well. Have you gone apple picking? A long time ago, I did apple picking. Basically, describe the band of nature in one sentence. I don't even know what that means, so I might have to research that up for you guys. What's the best way to read books? Again, that will correlate to the other one that you asked if I liked watching movies instead of being wrapped up in bed watching them or what have you. Sometimes also if I had a hard day, sometimes I'll be in a bath soaking in there with candlelit lights all over the place, as well as in saying this also, basically maybe some soft music basically while I'm reading a book in the bath, watching TV or working late. I'm a bit of either for this, obviously. I can be, depending on my mood, I'll probably be out and about raking leaves if I have to and if it's necessary, or else I'll be watching a bit of TV. But again, as I said, I usually am out and about, so therefore I'm out hiking and whatnot. My favourite colour basically, if it's not autumn themed, favourite colour usually, even though I'm in a, you know, at the moment and been wearing nudes and, you know, light pastel colours, so I'm a bit of a, you know, bit of those in between colours. Favourite full fashion? Oh, I don't know. Your long length trench coats versus basically if you're starting to nearing winter, it'd be your corduroy overalls versus, you know, thermal tops and whatnot. But then I can't think of anything else at the moment, but I'll hopefully show you some pictures that I like of the fashion that I've seen past and present that I like. And now, bad memory of autumn. I can't think of anything at the moment basically, because at this point of time, like, most of my memories are good time. Favorite makeup look. My favorite makeup look, if there was any basically, is of I've been trying out keep trying the actual smoky eye look, also as well as some other makeup looks I've been looking into. Favorite lip color for me basically is, like, I've noticed it depends on what I'm wearing, obviously depending on the change of season or just the seasons in general, based on what I'm wearing, could be like, again, beige or a few pastel pinks and hot reds maybe. Hat or cat person. Either, depending on basically, again, what I'm wearing, sort of thing, if it's in fashion or not. You know, I'm usually wearing my little cap around, be it my train conductor cap versus basically just a cap in general, or a baseball cap, so to speak. So this quickly ends a video for you guys. Hopefully you've learned something about me. If you have, let me know. Also, feel free to answer some of these questions, basically what you like about autumn, what you don't like about autumn, are you an outdoor person or are you an indoor person and whatnot. That'd be lovely, so that we can get a conversation going down below. And in saying this, thanks for all support that's watching, share these videos around, and also don't forget to smash the like and also subscribe on the bottom right hand corner, as I said before. And all further ado, guys, thanks for support, thanks for watching, do what you love, love what you're doing. Till next time, I'll see you again soon. Ciao for now.